Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive, and on the test bench today, we don't have my Victory VX100 Super Kraken that you've met 100,000 times. Rather, we're taking a look at what's concealed inside this Victory Vertical 2x12. It is in fact a pair of Celestion Redback speakers. Now, those of you familiar with Celestion's range will know that the Redback is essentially a high-powered, fire-breathing 150-watt driver, and I've actually got two of them in this little 2x12 cab, making for a total of 300 watts of handling. But the interesting thing about it is, unlike many other high-powered speakers on the market, it retains that classic Celestion crunch and character that we're so familiar with. So, realistically, in this review, there's very little talking I can actually do for you because I can only really describe how this speaker sounds, but why tell when you can show? So what we've got instead is we have our Redback cab lined up down here. We also have a matching Victory 2x12 over at the far side in black, and that contains a pair of vintage 30s that I've chosen because they're industry standard speakers for just about every amp manufacturer out there. And we all know what vintage 30s sound like with a microphone on them. To that effect, we've also chosen a single SM57 that we're going to be using to record all of these clips. And to keep things as fair as possible, what I'll be doing is I'll be recording a loop through our Super Kraken, and I'll play that same loop through both cabs. We'll leave the amp settings absolutely identical, and we've even measured the position of the microphone so it's the same place on both speakers. Now, what you'll probably notice if you, not to preemptively put ideas in your head, but what you'll notice is that the Redback has more of a less of a mid-focus tone, if you want to call it that. There's less of that upper mid spike. There's a little more extension in the top end and a lot more fullness in the bottom, which is somewhat similar to Celestion's Creamback Heavy. Now, this is just rumor and hearsay, but I have heard, little birds told me, that the Redback is based on the other prototype for the Creamback Heavy. So when they released the Creamback Heavy, there were two speaker designs in contention. One of them went on to be the Creamback Heavy. The other one was beefed up with a more powerful magnet and became the Redback. So people who are familiar with those Creambacks will know how it sounds and recognize that kind of tone quality in the Redback sound. So anyway, without further ado, we're going to record some loops. We'll do this in four different settings. We'll do a clean sound, we'll do some classic rock riffing, we'll do some heavy tones with some down-tuned riffs, and we'll also play some kind of singing, soaring lead lines. Let's start with some cleans though.
Thank you.
So I don't know about you, but the difference between those two speakers is pretty stark from where I'm sat, and I'm pretty sure that's going to play out in the recordings too. The Redbacks are a lot fuller and thicker in the low register with a much smoother top end, whereas the Vintage 30s have a more recessive bass and they're much more aggressive with that famous upper mid-range spike. So if, like me, you've never been particularly keen on that upper mid-range presence in Vintage 30s, the Redbacks will do you proud. However, for certain more aggressive styles, you might find that that aggressive upper mid-range is exactly what you need to help your sound carry. So it's really down to you. And of course, blending speakers is a very popular practice as well. You might get some really good results out of playing with a Vintage 30 and a Redback in your cab. Who knows? But for the time being, I'm going to leave you there. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive. These are the Celestion Redbacks, and I will see you next time. Thanks for checking out this video on the Guitar Interactive YouTube channel. We really do appreciate it. Drop us a comment below and let us know what you liked and what you think we should cover in the future. And check out these links here for more great content. We are, of course, your home for all things gear related, and we have killer interviews and tuition and all manner of stuff coming up for you in the near future. So hit that subscribe button down there. Make sure you hit the notification icon too, so we can keep you up to date with the latest and greatest news on all things guitar.